the afternoon, whichever.
We should say evening.
Yeah.
Evening business.
Please tell your friends and family.
Those are free.
But on first class.
So everyone will leave.
All of you will leave, then you go.
Which has been put together by the National Film Archive of India to celebrate the heroes and cinema that played homage to our soldiers. It's opportune that we open today, which I believe is Kargil Vijay Diwas as well. The National Film Archive, for some of you who may not know, was set up in February 1964 as a media unit of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Government of India, with the primary objective of acquiring and preserving Indian cinematic heritage. This includes preservation of film and non-film material, including, but not limited to, celluloid, stills, glass sides, posters, lobby cards, scripts, and song booklets. And so really, JKK is delighted in collaboration with the FTII, the Film and Television Institute of India, which I'm sure all of you know, and therefore you are here in such great numbers. Just a little bit about FTII. Established as Film Institute of India in 1960 on the erstwhile Prabhat Studio premises at Pune, FTII boasts of a rich legacy in quality Indian cinema. The Prabhat Studios were declared heritage sites by the Pune Municipal Corporation and are used by the students to this day. The institute was renamed the Film and Television Institute of India in 1971. The television wing, earlier located at Mandi House in New Delhi, was shifted to Pune in early 70s, bringing together the training in film and television under a common roof. The institute has come a long way from its very humble beginnings. Today, the FTII is commonly regarded as the center of excellence across the world for Indian cinema. Films are made by students of the institute, have enjoyed excellent receptions in festivals in India and abroad, and have gone on to win national and international awards. The FTII is an autonomous body under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, and its policies are determined by a governing council. We are really fortunate to have with us not only the director, Mr. Bhupendra Kenthola of the FTII, but also our film tutors who will be taking the course. I'd like very much at this point to invite Mr. Dhirendra Kumar Sharma ji from the NFAI to say a few words. Mr. D.K. Sharma has been serving at NFAI, the administrative officer, since 2012. He has joined government service in 2006 as the officer here. And as an administrative officer, he's vested with the responsibility for looking after administration, accounts, etc. He also looks after the efficient functioning and maintenance. We're very fortunate to have him, and we will be having the director, Mr. Prakash Mudum, who will come in later during the course to be with us. May I request you to come in?
Thank you, ma'am. Respected dignitaries on the dais, DG Madam, Director Sir, and dear participants, good morning, everyone. On behalf of FTII and National Film Archive of India, I welcome you all on the first edition of Short Course in Film Appreciation here at the colorful city of Jaipur. It is a matter of great privilege for us that this course is being organized in coordination with Jawahar Kala Kendra. Once Lord Buddha had said, it is better to travel well than to arrive. So this film appreciation course will keep on traveling and keep enlightening all of us on how to watch and appreciate this beautiful piece of art, effort and coordination of all those who put everything for making a film. I would like to thank DG Madam and her team for taking this initiative, and hope that you will see many more such courses on a regular basis. You all shall be brand ambassadors of NFAI and FTII. Hence, I would like to make an appeal to all of you that if you find any piece of cinematic art, be it photographs, be it film, short film, and posters, please donate it to National Film Archive of India. Your contribution will go a long way in preservation of such material. On concluding note, I invite you all to come and visit NFAI and FTII once in your lifetime to feel how cinema is lived and preserved. Thank you, and have a pleasant film appreciation course. Good day.
May I now request our faculty, the course directors, Mr. Subhamoy Sengupta, who's the course director, as well as Ms. Bela Negi. Mr. Subhamoy grew up in Kolkata, and he graduated in economics, at the same time spent an equal, if not greater, amount of time watching films at the Maxwell Bhavan. He joined the Film and Television Institute in Delhi and completed his specialization in direction, passing out in 1996. Arriving in Mumbai soon after, he assisted Sanjay Leela Bansali on his films Khamoshi and later Hum Dil De Chuke Sanam. Post that, he directed several single episode crime thrillers for Star and Z. He joined White Light, Mumbai's biggest production house then, as executive producer, and worked on more than 200 ad films in 3 years. Having worked in films, television and advertising films, Mr. Subhamoy started his production house, Nitric Films, in the year 2000. His production house makes commercials and films for state governments and tourism boards. He has also directed a short film, In the Dark, My Brother. Ms. Bela Negi, who is also our faculty, is a writer, director, and producer with Nitric Films, and which she set up along with Mr. Shubhoy Sengupta in 2000. After finishing studies in FTII, so you are this thing of FTII, a product of FTII, with a specialization in film editing in 1997, she assisted Renu Saluja, a prominent film editor, on 4 Bollywood films. She worked on short fiction and non-fiction as an independent editor. She has written and directed the feature film Dayan Ya Bayan, Hindi in 2010, a comedy set in a village in Uttarakhand. She also serves as a jury member in the NFAI panel in 2012 and 15. We're really happy to welcome you, who will be with us for the next 5 days leading the course, the film appreciation course. May we request you to say a few words.
Thank you so much for that introduction. It's lovely to be here. Thank you, DG ma'am, for having us here. Jawahar Kala Kendra, this is a beautiful, beautiful place. And we had a lovely morning, and it's great to see all of you here. So the idea that FTII in rolling out these courses basically is that in today's age, We are constantly surrounded by visual images. It's not like before that you go to a theater, you see a film, or you sit down in your house and you watch a television serial or the news. These days, anywhere you go, on your mobile, on your laptop, hoardings, moving images, it's prevalent everywhere. You know, people are watching things while they're walking, on the train, on the bus. So the concept of visual literacy, therefore, has become very, very important in this time, because these images are saying various things to us. They're trying to sell us ideas, ideologies, sometimes things, you know, commercial goods. So it's very important for us to understand what are these images doing to us, because often they are communicating many things to us without us even realizing it. We don't even realize how they are influencing our thought process. So therefore, the relevance of this film appreciation course has become very, very important in this day and age. And I'm very, very glad to be here, and I hope we're going to have like a fun 5 days where we're going to watch a lot of interesting films and you know, engage in very interesting discussions. Thank you so much.
And finally, last but not least, certainly, I'd like to invite Mr. Bhupendra Kantola, who's the director of FTII. Mr. Bhupendra Kantola is an Indian Information Service officer of 1989 batch and has been appointed as the new director of FTII recently. He holds a master's in international relations from the University of Mumbai and has served as director newsroom with DD News since January 2015 and was responsible for the management of news operations and output. Previously, he has worked with PIP, Directorate of Audiovisual Publicity, DAVP, Director of Film Festival, as Director, National Film Awards and Indian Panorama, and Lok Sabha Television. Thank you so much for being with us and for partnering with JKK, which we hope is the beginning of many such partnerships. Please, we have to say a few words.
Very good morning to all of you. Just as I am speaking to you right now, there is a film appreciation course going on in the University of Kashmir in Srinagar. Just day before yesterday, we inaugurated a course there. And we were pleasantly surprised to see 100 plus Kashmiri young people enrolling for the course. It was on 4th of July that I visited Srinagar as part of a film festival being held there, while being fully aware that cinema halls had closed down in Srinagar 25 years ago. So just imagine, one full generation has grown up in the Kashmir Valley without seeing a film on a big screen. So when I met the Vice Chancellor of the university and I told him that we would like to hold some short courses here, he surprised me by being very forthcoming. He said, yes, please do. Tell me, when do you want to start? And it was a dream come true that on the 4th of July, I went to Kashmir. On the 24th of July, we started a film appreciation course. And it broke many stereotypes, because sitting here in Jaipur or sitting in Pune, we have some images about Kashmir. But I was surprised to see that 40% of the students were young girls. They were wearing burqa, they were wearing hijab, but they were there to understand cinema. It is visuals that we saw in Srinagar that really drives me to hold more such courses across the country. We are here in Jaipur today to start a film appreciation course, which I understand has never been held before. For many years, film appreciation has been the forte of FTII. From 1967, in fact, this is the golden jubilee year. For 50 years, film appreciation courses have been held by FTII, but only in Pune. So there was a thirst, there was a hunger, there was a demand to hold these courses across the country. And we sensed it because I have been traveling a lot. And I got a sense that there are many towns and cities where there are people interested in cinema. Why should only Bengal and Kerala be the leaders in understanding, in making good films? Why should all the big, great names of cinema come only from these two places? Why can't there be big names from Rajasthan, from Jammu Kashmir, from Uttarakhand, from Himachal? With that idea in mind, FTII recently undertook an initiative called SKIFT, Skilling India in Film and Television. Film appreciation course is one component of that initiative. The other areas where we are now going into are digital cinematography. 20-day courses we are launching across the country. Right now, a digital cinematography course is going on in Port Blair, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. 3,500 kilometers from Jaipur, in the middle of Andamans, we are conducting a course. 24 young boys and girls are getting trained in digital cinematography. For a young man from Port Blair to learn digital cinematography, the person has to travel all the way to either Kolkata or Chennai. And you'll be surprised to know that Bangkok is closer to Port Blair than Chennai and Kolkata. So we are taking these courses to these far off places because this is where we feel there is talent, there are opportunities, but there are no opportunities. Other course that we are also planning to launch, we have already held it in Delhi and Mumbai, is screenplay writing. We have held two courses in Delhi of screenplay writing and two film appreciation courses, which were heavily oversubscribed. In Mumbai, from the 17th of July, August, we are starting three courses: digital cinematography, screenplay writing, and acting. In Uttarakhand, in Haridwar, we are starting a film appreciation course from 23rd of August. In Guwahati, we are going there on the 13th of September. So these are the things that we have in mind. We want to take these courses outside the metros. There is nothing, no harm, there is no bias we have against the metros. Metros are important. But it is important that we take such courses to smaller towns and cities. One reason why we have come to Jaipur is very similar to one reason why we go to Srinagar or we go to Dehradun. And that is that the number of students from Rajasthan are very few in the campus. I have completed 15 months now in FTII. And there is only one Kashmiri student in the whole campus. Out of 260 odd students in the campus, there is only one Kashmiri. And I don't think there are more than two or three people from Rajasthan in the campus. Unless we come here, unless we hold these courses across the country, we will never be able to tap the talent, the potential that is lying untapped. And the only way to start is a film appreciation course. That is the bread and butter of anybody who wants to see film seriously. And many people have started their film careers through film appreciation. One of the biggest names is Ashutosh Gowarikar. Ashutosh Gowarikar was just a film enthusiast until he did a film appreciation course in Pune. And that drove him to become a filmmaker. And there are many other big names. There are many people here who have first done a film appreciation, understood the nuances, and then given a serious thought with whether they want to take it up as a career or not. So I'm very hopeful that we will see more people from Rajasthan in FTII. In fact, there are fewer candidates also who write the exam. So perhaps we might hold an admission seminar this year for the first time in Jaipur. Ahead of the admissions in FTII, where we conduct 11 courses, 7 in films and 4 in television, we are planning to now hold admission seminars in states from where the response is low, from where not many people write the exams. Jaipur is one of those places. So in the month of December, perhaps in this very venue, with the permission of Jawahar, we'll have an admission seminar for FTII. Let hundreds of young people from Rajasthan come. We'll get our faculty here to answer your questions, how to prepare for the All India entrance exam, because our entrance exams are as competitive as the IIT exams. 4,000 people roughly write FTII exams every year, and 110 are selected. So the 3,890 people who are left out are the kind of people who we are trying to reach through these short courses. Why should you give up on your dreams? Why should you extinguish your dreams just because you couldn't get into FTII? And maybe if you are interested in cinematography and you do a 20-day course that we are offering,
It will help you take a big decision of your life, whether this is your cup of tea or not. You may be a photographer. You may be a videographer who is shooting marriages, for instance. A person who is shooting a marriage for a livelihood, tomorrow if that person has an ambition to graduate to making a documentary, why should he give up on that dream? So FTII is there now to fulfill all such dreams. And our FA courses, our film appreciation courses, are attended by doctors, lawyers, engineers, housewives, everyone. Because to different people, it means different things. To some, an FA course is simply an expression of a hobby, an interest in cinema. For someone else, it's a way of trying to find out whether cinema can really be my source of living. For somebody else, it can be an academic research, because there are lots of university teachers who come and attend our courses. So film appreciation means different things to different people. And we have charted out a major plan to roll out these courses everywhere. And as I said, the short courses, digital cinematography, screenplay writing, acting. There is one more thing that is of my interactions with the Mumbai industry. I have seen that if today there is a demand for one single profession, that is for writers. There is absolutely a major demand. People tell me that there are no good screenwriters. Even for television, there are very few writers who write well, which is why you see a lot of trash on cinema, on TV these days. We have been in talks with the Mumbai industry for a long time on how to devise a course on writing for television, writing for TV fiction. After 6 months of consulting, finally on the 3rd of July, FTII started a 5-month residential course, writing for TV fiction and web series. As you know, Netflix, Amazon, they are all hiring writers now. But there are no trained writers. We held an All India, we put out advertisements, and 17 promising young boys and girls are today in FTII from 3rd of July, learning the art of writing television fiction. We plan to hold these courses twice a year. The next course will be up in February. I will request you all to keep visiting FTII website. All the new courses that we are doing in the campus, outside the campus, in smaller towns, we'll all be putting it on our website. And we'll make sure that we reach out to every major town, every big city of this country. For the next 5 days, I wish you all the best. I'm personally very happy we have got two of our finest teachers of film appreciation with you, Bela, Negi and Subhamoy, Sengupta. They did a course for us in Delhi, and the feedback we got was tremendous. So we thought we'll get our best to Jaipur, and that's what we have done here, and we have come here today. All the very best to you. Thank you.
Mr. Kentola, and I'd just like to say that we hope our collaboration with FTII continues. As everybody knows, from Jaipur, the JKK is a very important center of art and culture, and in our attempt to make it even a better center of excellence, we hope we can continue with these collaborations and bring to all of you here not only appreciation courses but a series of films and so on and so forth, and perhaps some of the training courses as well. I'd just like to say that every evening for the next 5 days, we have public, for the public, and not just for all of us here, a series of films which have been provided by NFAI. We've got the list put outside, and I welcome you all to tell your friends and family to come. We start at 7 sharp. And with this, I'd like to say thank you again, and we'd like to begin the course. Thank you so much.
So basically, for the next 5 days, as we all heard, we're going to do a lot of film viewing, we're going to see film clips, we're going to discuss films. So film, as you know, today stands at just a little more than 120 years old. But this process was not obviously like a one-point eureka kind of an invention. It was basically a devolution dependent on the number of factors that are constant till today. और वो फैक्टर्स क्या क्या है वो फैक्टर्स ब्रॉडली है यू नीड एन एस्थेटिक यू नीड अ टेक्नोलॉजी यू नीड एन इकोनॉमी एंड एन ऑडियंस तो इन द नेक्स्ट 5 days वी एज एन ऑडियंस विल ट्राई एंड एनालाइज एंड अंडरस्टैंड द एस्थेटिक्स एंड द टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ फिल्म एंड ऑब्वियसली द इकोनॉमी कैन टेक केयर ऑफ इटसेल्फ
28 taka GST ke rate pe. That's a joke. Anyway, that aside, so basically, coming back to your schedule, so today, basically, we have in the morning two sessions. The day will be divided into a pre-lunch and a post-lunch session. Post-lunch will be a feature film screening every day, followed by a discussion. And pre-lunch today, there'll be a talk on the grammar of the visual language, film as a visual medium, and what that basically means. Post that, we'll be seeing some short films and we'll be discussing. Tomorrow we'll go on to film history, not just in terms of dates and names, but also in terms of understanding what movements and main genres, how it evolved. Tisra then, which is day after tomorrow, we'll be doing film techniques, effective use of editing, cinematography, sound, acting styles in films. Fourth day, we'll be touching upon animation, we'll be doing regional films, we'll be doing the role of an Indian woman in Indian films. And the fifth day, we'll have an award-winning short film screening with the directors present and a lecture on restoration of films. And we'll also be seeing a restored film that day. So right now we'll be starting off with the first session of the first day. Yeah, and I'll call Bela to start it off.
आपके दिमाग को और आपकी thought process को affect करता है और इस तरह से आप ना सिर्फ एक you know you will be a better film audience पर आपकी जो विजुअल लैंग्वेज के बारे में अवेयरनेस है वो भी बढ़ेगी. सो फोटोग्राफी प्रिसीडेड सिनेमा बाय ऑलमोस्ट 50 इयर्स, द स्टिल फोटोग्राफ. और उस समय क्या था, फोटोग्राफी का क्लेम क्या था कि इट इज़ एन एग्जैक्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ लाइफ. क्योंकि उस समय पेंटिंग्स हुआ करती थी, यू नो दे यूज़ टू रिप्रेजेंट थिंग्स अराउंड देम. और फोटोग्राफी व्हेन इट जो नई थी, व्हाट वाज इट ट्राइंग टू से, दैट दिस इज एन एग्जैक्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ लाइफ एंड दैट इज हाउ इट वाज सीन. बट अ लॉट ऑफ थिंकर्स अटैक्ड दिस नोशन कि कोई भी फोटोग्राफ एक एग्जैक्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ लाइफ हो ही नहीं सकता है. क्यों नहीं हो सकता है? बिकॉज व्हेन एवर यू आर फोटोग्राफिंग समथिंग, जो आर्टिस्ट है, जो फोटोग्राफर है, उसका एक इंटरप्रिटेशन हमेशा बीच में आ जाता है. तो आप अगर एक फोटोग्राफ लें और आप अगर एक फोटोग्राफ लें और मैं एक फोटोग्राफ, सेम सब्जेक्ट, वो क्या एग्जैक्टली सेम होगा? कभी भी नहीं, क्योंकि उसमें एक एंगल चेंज होगा, एक एटीट्यूड चेंज होगा और थोड़ा सा एक फर्क आ जाता है. तो ये जो नोशन है कि फोटोग्राफी और सिनेमा can be an exact representation of life is not really true. So I just want to, you know, just show you a slide. Okay. Now aap is image ko dekhiye. Right? आपको क्या दिखता है? जस्ट एनीबडी, आप ब्लैक टी शर्ट में, आपको क्या दिख रहा है इस इमेज में? कुछ भी आपको जो दिमाग में आ, अच्छा, एक लड़की एक पीछे देख रही है. ओके, एनीबडी एल्स? हाँ, बार डांसर. ओके, हाँ, ओके, इनको एक बूढ़ी औरत दिख रही है. हाँ,
दाढ़ी वाला व्यक्ति.
अच्छा, ओके, दाढ़ी वाला व्यक्ति. ओके, जस्ट तो आप देखिए, मतलब ये एक ही इमेज है, उसमें इनको एक यंग लड़की दिखी. शायद ये इनकी जो करंट स्टेट ऑफ माइंड है, ये शायद एक लड़की को ढूंढ रहे हैं तो इमीडिएटली इनको एक लड़की दिखी. और ये अनदर यंग मैन, ही सॉ एन ओल्ड वुमन, तो आई डोंट नो व्हाट ही इज सीकिंग. तो बट इट इज, दिस इज एक्चुअली अ वेरी फेमस इल्यूजन, यू नो, जिसमें बोथ आर ट्रू. If you see ek bodi aurat hai, kini ko to ek daadi bhi dikhi, and there is, this is a very famous illusion, jisme ek ladki bhi aapko dikhti hai, aur ek bodi aurat bhi dikhti hai. We'll just move on, we'll come to the questions later. To isme, now the same thing is, that is what I'm trying to say, ki aap jab bhi ek image ko dekhte hain, there is a lot of subjectivity. Aapka personal, political, social, उस समय क्या कॉन्टेक्स्ट है उन उस नज़रिए से आप एक पिक्चर को देखते हैं और उस समय शायद आपको वो दिखता है या नहीं दिखता है राइट सो ऑफ कर लीजिए पहले जो विजुअल आर्ट था वो हमेशा एक अलग सी एक जगह में होता था या तो जैसे हमारे स्कल्पचर्स हैं पेंटिंग्स हैं टेम्पल्स में हुआ करते थे या जैसे केव पेंटिंग्स हैं वो कहीं एक अलग जाके आपको वो देखना पड़ता था तो उस वजह से जो हमारा उसके तरफ एक फीलिंग था वो भी एक वी वर ऑलवेज इन ऑ ऑफ दैट क्योंकि हम एक मंदिर में जाते हैं तो हमारा जो मानसिक स्थिति है वो अलग है Later, this art entered a social sphere, जैसे museums में, palaces में, आप architecture, sculptures, paintings देखने लगे. पर फिर भी ये social sphere में आके भी, it was not part of our daily life. We still had to go somewhere. We had to go to a museum. We had to go to a palace. To see all these paintings, to see the architecture. So still it exercised a sense of power over us. Now what has happened in this day and age? Because of modern means of reproduction, we see these visuals everywhere. You know, it has lost that sanctity, jo ek, hame ek feeling of awe aata tha, wo abhi thoda bahut hat gaya hai usse. क्योंकि आप देखेंगे लाइक इफ यू गो टू द लूव्र जहाँ पे मोनालिजा की पेंटिंग है द फेमस मोनालिजा पेंटिंग और आप वो पेंटिंग देखें एक ब्लैंक वॉल में एक बड़े से कमरे में अकेले एक पेंटिंग टकी हुई है जो सेंस आप में वो इवोक होगा और आप अगर एक बस में जा रहे हैं और एक लड़की ने टी शर्ट पहना है और वो मोनालिजा का एक पेंटिंग उसकी छपी हुई है तो क्या आपको सिमिलर फीलिंग होगी एकदम अलग होगा ओके सो आर्ट हैज नाउ मूव्ड फ्रॉम दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ वेरी सॉर्ट ऑफ यू नो प्रेशियस प्रिजर्व टू अ मोर कॉमन प्लेस सो द पावर दैट इट एक्सरसाइज बिकम वेरी अवेलेबल पहले आपको फ्रांस जाना पड़ता था यू नो टू सी पेंटिंग्स आपको इधर जाना पड़ता था उधर जा टू सी फिल्म्स यू हैड टू गो टू अ थिएटर टू सी सर्टेन पेंटिंग्स आप म्यूजियम्स में जाते थे टुडे यू जस्ट ऑन अ क्लिक यू कैन सी दोज इमेजेस सो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज दैट हैव दीज इमेजेस लॉस्ट देयर पावर यू नो जो एक हम में वो एक इवोक करता था क्या वो चला गया है थोड़ा बहुत तो सही है कि अभी अगर आप अपने मोबाइल पे सारे बड़े बड़े आर्टिस्ट की पेंटिंग्स देख सकते हैं और एक फिल्म को आप बस में चलते चलते रास्ते चलते चलते तो वो एक थोड़ा एक इक्वेशन बदल गया है बट द थिंग इज दैट वाइल दैट सेंस ऑफ ऑ इज नॉट देयर बट अ डिफरेंट पावर With us understanding this new sort of presence of visuals around us, we can confer the visuals a new kind of power. अगर हम समझ सकें कि इन visuals को कैसे हम use करें, we can, you know, the visuals can gain a different kind of power. Okay, so I'll just give you an example. Next slide. What? Just look at it as a visual. Not as a painting or anything. What is the emotion that evokes in us? Somebody at the back? Just anybody. Just one or two words to explain. Aapko kya feeling aa rahi hai isko dekh ke? Please lift your hands. And, yeah.
मैं पीछे कुछ तूफान जैसा दिखाया गया जो ब्लू शेडो में है उसके आसपास कुछ पक्षी उड़ रहे हैं
हाँ नहीं आप मुझे पेंटिंग में डिस्क्राइब करिए मुझे क्या फीलिंग आपके उसमें आती है वो बोलिए हाँ ओके केओस ऑलराइट
टूटी हुई लाइंस
ओके हाँ फीलिंग्स आई डोंट वांट डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दैट आई कैन सी व्हाट इट इज हाँ व्हाट इज द फीलिंग्स इट्स इवोकिंग लोनलीनेस ऑलराइट ओके नाउ वी जस्ट ओके नाउ वी हैव दिस लाइन हियर This is Van Gogh's last painting before he killed himself. तो आपको जो सेंस आया था chaos और loneliness का, that becomes even more. आप अगर ये पिक्चर के साथ ये लाइन देखते हैं क्या होता है? You know that sense is heightened. Please, when there is a point of discussion, then we'll have a discussion. All right? So that sense is heightened just because of that line. That goes with it. So this is called juxtaposition. आप juxtaposition समझते हैं कि एक visual को किसी और चीज के साथ either another visual or with a line we put it together. We put it next to each other. So what happens? The whole emotion of that visual changes or becomes more in this case. क्योंकि आपको chaos तो already लग रहा था, loneliness already लग रहा था. So now that sense gets heightened. This is, by the way, Van Gogh's last painting before he killed himself, as it says. So now we are talking about like a new language of images. If we use it differently, there are endless possibilities. Because as we know, seeing comes before words. Ek bachcha hamesha pehle dekhta hai, and then he learns how to speak. So seeing is actually an activity that we know much before we learn language. And that is what we are now moving towards, exploring the power of the visual language in new ways. So now, again to emphasize the point that we made earlier, ki aap ek chitra ko dekhte hain, like for instance, if you see a rose, jab aap written language mein, if you read a paragraph about a rose, बहुत सुंदर रोज है एक गार्डन में खिल रहा है यू नो और उसमें हल्की सी कुछ पानी की बूंदें हैं व्हेन यू रीड आप एक बुक में पढ़ते हैं आप क्या कर रहे हैं आपका दिमाग
इमेजरी क्रिएट
हाँ इट इज क्रिएटिंग इट्स ओन इमेजरी वो मैं आपको नहीं बता रही हूँ वो आपके अपने एक्सपीरियंस से आपने कौन सा रोज आपको पसंद है या आपने ज़्यादा देखा है उसका क्या कलर है वो आप यू आर फीलिंग इट But what happens in when you're seeing a photograph or a, you know, moving image? I am telling you more specific details. So if you see a clip of a rose, what happens? आपको color मैं बता रही हूँ. मैंने photograph लिया. मैं आपको color बता रही हूँ. किस angle से लिया गया है? ऊपर से या नीचे से या दूर से या एकदम पास से? उसमें कैसी light पड़ रही है? तो ये सब चीजें I am dictating to you. So whenever, there can never be subjectivity so much of, there's always subjectivity when you're interpreting, what happens is the filmmaker and the artist is interpreting things for you. And therefore is influencing you in a greater way than words can influence you. That is the power of cinema. Because I am giving you very, very specific information. I am giving you very specific information, leaving less to your imagination. Okay. So now, this brings us to cinema, which is not only an image, which is a moving image. Okay. So let's, to start off with, see this clip. Okay, we'll just play this clip again. This, as I said, was the first film that was publicly screened. In 1895, it's called The Train Arriving at the Station. Okay. थिएटर से, क्योंकि उनको लगा बट दे आर नॉट यूज्ड टू इट, यू नो. तो एज दिस ट्रेन वॉज अप्रोचिंग पीपल स्टार्टेड रनिंग अवे फ्रॉम द थिएटर बिकॉज उनको लगा वो ट्रेन उनको आके मार देगी, यू नो. देन द फर्स्ट टाइम व्हेन पीपल सॉ क्लोज अप समझते हैं तो डर गए बिकॉज दे थॉट समबडीज हेड इज बीन कट ऑफ एंड यू नो एंड पुट ऑन द स्क्रीन. So today we have moved a long way. I mean, it's been more than, 100 years, almost 125 years since, this first screening. And hum kafi aage badh gaye. Hum aajkal kai tarah ki language, bahut kisam ki structure, you know, different kinds of storytelling we understand. Because we have become so used to the visual medium and we are used to seeing so many kinds of films. Our fascination with cinema has not diminished. Even after 125 years, we still, I think, like to go to a theater, you know, to watch a film in complete darkness. And what is it, cinema ke baare mein ye kya hai jo hume itna fascinate karta hai? So the first thing about cinema is that light. How do we see cinema? In a dark hall, it is the only source of light. अंधेरे में हम एक वहाँ से एक लाइट का प्रोजेक्शन होता है एंड दैट्स हाउ वी सी अ फिल्म, यू नो. एंड व्हाट इज लाइट? लाइट इज द बिगनिंग ऑफ एवरीथिंग, यू नो. व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट लाइट, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनलाइटनमेंट. इट इज हाउ वी सी एनीथिंग, वी रिकग्नाइज शेप्स एंड दैट इज हाउ सिनेमा फंक्शंस, यू नो. इट इज अ प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ लाइट ऑन टू अ स्क्रीन. द सेकेंड थिंग अबाउट सिनेमा इज मूवमेंट. Academic studies bhi hui hai, terminology hai, mostly exist in English. So within those constraints, we will try and include Hindi. Aur hum bahut ek complicated English mein baat nahi kar rahe hain, aur jitna Hindi mein ho saka, wo bhi hum include karenge. So anyway, and I would request please everybody not to interrupt, you know, always raise your hand and please talk, because there will be a time for discussion and that's when we're going to talk. All right, so we were talking about what is it that is fascinating about cinema. We talked about light, how, you know, it is a projection of light onto a screen. Dusra cheez hai cinema ke bare mein, movement. And man has always been fascinated with movement, you know. To aapko, aapke pardada ji ya koi batate honge ki pehle wo, you know, मेलों में वो ऐसा zoetrope आता था, उसमें अगर आप bioscope, you know, और आप उसमें आग डालेंगे तो आपको moving images दिखती थी. But even आपने भी देखा होगा कभी मेलों में, and you know, you have those little cameras जो जिससे आप हाथ को rotate कर सकते हैं. So now even 30,000 years ago, Chauvet, एक फ्रांस में जगह है जहाँ पे केव पेंटिंग्स हैं, उसको हम देखेंगे. सो मैन हैज ऑलवेज बीन फैसिनेटेड विद द आइडिया ऑफ कैप्चरिंग मूवमेंट, यू नो. इफ यू सी, दीज आर द केव पेंटिंग्स ऑफ शोवे विच आर 30,000 इयर्स ओल्ड. वो मल्टीपल हॉर्न्स जो आप देख रहे हैं, परहैप्स दैट इज द आर्टिस्ट वे ऑफ ट्राइंग टू कैप्चर मूवमेंट. Okay, we go to this again, you know, these lines. What is the sense that you get here? A sense of movement, right? So at that time, the artist is trying to get that sense of movement. And finally, when did man achieve, you know, when was he actually able to capture movement? Only 125 years ago, approximately. So that is why we are so fascinated with film and with visual, because all this while, this is the first time that we are able to capture movement in a real way. Okay. Now the third thing, please, I request everybody to switch off the mobiles. The third thing is ki in cinema what happens? Aap ek clip dekhte hain, ek aadmi apne ghar se nikalta hai. Dusra aap dekhte hain ki wo train mein baitha hua hai. इसके बीच में क्या हुआ है वो आप अपने आप दिमाग से यू आर इन्फरिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड इन्फरेंस तो आप अंदाजा लगा रहे हैं कि हाँ ये घर से निकला फिर सड़क में चढ़ा होगा फिर चल के आया होगा फिर सीढ़ी चढ़ा होगा और अब ट्रेन में टिकट खरीदा होगा अभी ट्रेन में बैठ रहा है सो दिस एबिलिटी इन आर माइंड टू फिल इन दीज ब्लैंक्स दिस इज कॉल्ड इन्फरेंस ओके नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो फैसिनेटिंग थिंग कि लैंग्वेज आज इतनी आगे बढ़ गई है सिनेमा लैंग्वेज की वी डोंट नीड टू बी टोल्ड एग्जैक्टली व्हाट द स्टोरी इज हम खुद ही एक अंदाजा लगा लेते हैं आवर माइंड इमेजिन्स व्हाट इज नॉट देयर ऑन द स्क्रीन सो एंड ऑल्सो अनदर फैसिनेटिंग थिंग इज टाइम नाउ व्हेन वी सी दिस क्लिप When we see this clip, अभी जो आपने देखा train arriving at a station, for that moment क्या होता है आप 1895 में transport हो जाते हैं कि नहीं आपको लगता है कि because film has been able to capture that time forever, you know, तो that time can be replayed to everybody at any point. You know, so this is also a very, very important aspect of cinema. Tabhi bhi aap jaise 1940 ki agar film dekhen, to jab aap hall mein hain, us samay ke liye aapko kya lagta hai? Ki aap, you are transported into the year 1940, right? So that is the power of cinema, that it can actually take you back and forth in time. Or if you see a futuristic film, maan lijiye, ki you know, the year 3000, This will what the world will be. For that period of time, what happens? That you feel that you are ahead in time. So, and the language of cinema is the most universal language. Hindi, English, German, you know, all over the world, when you show a visual clip, that cuts across through many people. यू नो आपको कभी कभी जब साइलेंट सिनेमा होता था वो पूरे दुनिया में दिखाई जाती थी कोई वर्ड्स की जरूरत ही नहीं है बिकॉज हर कोई उसको समझ सकता है सो इट इज मच मोर ऑफ अ यूनिवर्सल लैंग्वेज देन एनीथिंग एल्स इज एंड जो उसका जो इमोशन है जो सिनेमा में कन्वे होता है दैट कट्स थ्रू टू एवरीबडी एवरीवेयर वी सी अ हॉलीवुड फिल्म वी सी अ स्पेनिश फिल्म क्या होता है डू वी नॉट आइडेंटिफाई या हमें लगता है चाहिए तो वहाँ की बात है ऐसा तो नहीं होता है ना आपको लगता है कि ये यहाँ पे यू बिकॉज यू आइडेंटिफाइंग विद द इमोशंस दैट दैट फिल्म इज कन्वेइंग टू यू सो फॉर मी आई मीन मैं आपको बोलूँगी कि यू नो आई वॉज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ लिटरेचर एंड आई हैड नो इंटेंशन एंड आई यूज टू डू थिएटर एंड आई हैड नो इंटेंशन ऑफ एक्चुअली गेटिंग इन टू फिल्म मेकिंग बट वन डे आई रेड जॉर्ज ओवेल आपने सुना होगा यू नो इज अ वेरी ग्रेट राइटर एंड इज रिटन ऑल्सो लॉट ऑफ एसेज और एक ऐसे मैंने पढ़ा जिसमें वो जो सिनेमा का जो पावर है उसके बारे में बात करते हैं और उन्होंने क्या बोला कि सिनेमा हैज द एबिलिटी कि अगर आपको मान लीजिए एक सपना आया है एक नाइट मेयर यू हैड अ नाइट मेयर और आप अपने फ्रेंड को बताना चाहते हैं कि मैंने एक बहुत बुरा सपना देखा पता है उसमें एक मतलब एक अंधेरी गली थी और उसमें एक लाल रंग था यू फाइंड दैट वर्ड्स आर इनएडिक्वेट यू आर नेवर एबल टू एग्जैक्टली कन्वे क्या आपको डर लगा था उस नाइटमेयर में आपकी क्या एग्जैक्ट फीलिंग्स थी वेयर इज इफ यू कैन पुट दैट इन फिल्म दैट कम्स एज क्लोज टू कम्युनिकेटिंग यू नो योर नाइटमेयर एज पॉसिबल एंड दैट्स व्हाट एक्चुअली गॉट मी इंटरेस्ट इन सिनेमा आई सेड या समटाइम्स वर्ड्स आर इनएडिक्वेट कभी यू नो आपको लगेगा कि ये हम वर्ड्स में हम ये बातें नहीं कह पाते हैं यू नो But with visuals, it is easier to convey what the filmmaker wants to convey. So let's, I just want to show you a series of, aapne Rembrandt, ek bahut famous painter hai, 16th century painter, aapne unke baare mein suna hi hoga. Nahi bhi suna to koi baat nahi. I mean, he was somebody who did a lot of self-portraits. Matlab, wo khud ke chitr unhone apne throughout his life he made. और वो चित्र देख के जब आप देखते हैं अलग अलग से तो आपको लगेगा इट हैज़ अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इमोशनल इम्पैक्ट ऑन यू पर somebody has actually strung these all these pictures together into making a moving image और वो मूविंग इमेज का जो पावर है वो कुछ अलग ही है, उसको हम अभी देखेंगे. सुंदर फोटो पेंटिंग्स हैं, बट व्हेन यू स्ट्रिंग देम, दिस इज कॉल्ड मॉर्फिंग. ये जो टेक्निक यूज की गई है एक पेंटिंग से दूसरे में जो जा रहा है, इट हैज अ वेरी डिफरेंट इफेक्ट, यू नो. सो अ मूविंग इमेज कैन डू मच मोर देन जस्ट अ सीरीज ऑफ फोटोग्राफ्स. सो दिस वाज जस्ट टू इलस्ट्रेट दैट पॉइंट. Okay, now we come to the beginnings of cinema. I mean, before cinema was recognized as an art, कि cinema को जब हम कला कहने लगे उससे पहले people used to look down on cinema. You know, it was कि ये क्या है, this is just an exact representation of reality. You know, और कला के लिए आपको क्या करना है, that it cannot be an exact representation. कला is always an artist's interpretation of reality. But हमने वो पहले ही डिस्कस कर दिया है कि कभी एक ऑब्जेक्टिव एक रियलिटी कभी भी नहीं पोर्ट्रे हो सकती. इवन वेन यू आर मेकिंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट्री, इवन इफ वेन यू आर मेकिंग अ न्यूज रिपोर्ट, देर इज नथिंग कॉल एन ऑब्जेक्टिव पोर्ट्रेल. द मोमेंट देर इज अ पर्सन कमिंग इन बिटवीन रियालिटी एंड एन ऑडियंस, देर इज ऑलवेज एन इंटरप्रिटेशन that happens. आप agree करते हैं कि नहीं? अगर आप news report देखें एक channel में और दूसरे channel में, आपको हमेशा एक सी लगती है क्या news report? There's always a difference in the way it is being presented, the way it is in, it has been shot. All right? So earlier what cinema was trying to do, it was still trying to find its feet. तो क्या होता था कि क्या shoot करते थे? कुछ अलग-अलग चीजें, जैसे दो बिल्लियों की लड़ाई, या कुछ औरतें कुछ कर रही हैं, या ट्रेन आ रही है. तो इट वॉज लाइक अ नॉवल्टी शो, यू नो. तो पीपल यूज टू फाइंड सम इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट्स, इधर उधर जाते थे, दे यूज टू शूट दैट. सो दैट इज हाउ सिनेमा मेड इट्स बिगनिंग्स. बट स्लोली द फिल्म मेकर्स डिस्कवर्ड दैट इट इज नॉट न्यू थिंग्स दैट यू नीड टू सी, इट इज द वे यू सी लाइफ अराउंड यू, the everyday life, that is what makes a good film. You know, I mean, आप देखें कि कितनी कहानियाँ हैं जो हम बार 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 वही कहानी बोलते रहते हैं, पर किस तरीके से हम बोलते हैं और अपनी एक नई आंखों से जब हम चीज़ों को देखते हैं, दैट इज वॉट मेक्स आर्ट इंटरेस्टिंग. So, and you know, in its journey, cinema borrowed from many things. Aur wo jo sari kalaye hai, usse cinema ne borrow kiya. For example, it borrowed from paintings, as we, you know, it was seen as like earlier paintings kis liye banate the. Sometimes, I mean, apart from an artistic expression, painters used to be hired, jaise aapke yahan raja maharajaon ki kitni sari paintings hai. So they used to hire an artist so that they could take a, almost like a photograph. Painting kya tha? Ek photograph tha ki aap raja ko kaise represent kare. To fir jab photography aa gayi, to it borrowed from paintings. And again, I'll show you a little clip which shows that even today, there are a lot of frames from in our films that we continue to borrow from. Film clip that has been inspired by it. Lights off, Kartijan.